Hello friends, I am Sampada Kulkarni, welcomes you in my channel Tech Talks. Today I am going to explain you the binary search iterative program in C for both ascending as well as descending order list. What the changes you are supposed to do if you are having a code and if you want to find out a search key in a given list, if it is in ascending order or it is in descending order. Before moving to IDE, I would like to suggest you that go through the introduction of binary search. What is binary search? How to perform binary search? What is the algorithm? What is time complexity? And all in my introduction video. For your simplicity, I am providing a shortcut link in this write-up corner. After that, you can also go through the C program in which I have already explained the iterative execution of the binary search. So now let's move to the IDE. In this IDE, I have already written the program in which I have written a code in C language for ascending ordered list. Here you can see that this is the code for accepting the number of elements in your array. This is the code for accepting the elements for your array, number of elements from your array, in your array. Now here you are going to accept the key from a user. Now here this is the logic of your binary search, where you are assigning low to 0, high to n minus 1, that is higher boundary. Every time we need to find out a middle by applying a formula low plus high divided by 2. This is the divide and conquer algorithm, that's why we need to find out a mid, and we need to check whether your key element is present at mid or not. Now this is the main key point over here, that if the list is in ascending order and if my key is less than mid, it will appear in which segment of the list? Where it will appear? Can you think about that? If my key is greater than the mid center of a list or the number present in my key number will be present in the right sublist. So if the right sublist is there, I need to update my low variable, and after that again I need to go forward to check whether now updated, I need to find out the mid point over here, updated mid, and again I need to check whether the updated mid is less than key or not. So iteratively I need to perform all these tasks. This is the thing, if my key is greater than mid. If it is equal to mid, the key search is successful. Otherwise, if key is not greater than mid, I need to move to the left sublist, and in this case I need to update my high bound. Here by mistake I have written the lower bound, but here it should be the high bound. I need to update the high bound. In if these three cases are not true, then I need to iteratively perform the task again and again by updating or recalculating the mid. And either of the case is true, it indicates that our search is performing, and at the end if my middle value is equal to key, the searching of key is successful. Otherwise, if iteratively my low is going to be increased by high, then it indicates that the number is not present. So now I have already executed the code over here. Well, the 5 numbers I have accepted from a user, 55, 66, 77, 88, 99. The key number which I want to search is 88, and 88 is found at location 4. This is the code for ascending ordered list. If the same program I want to change from ascending ordered list to descending ordered list, only the change between this symbol. Here from greater, if my mid, the value present at mid is less than key, this I need to do if my list is in ascending order. And now I am putting the symbol is like the mid value present in my array is greater than key. This is I am going to write down for the ascending ordered array. Now let's execute the code and let's check whether what I am getting the output. For the again same number, but I need to insert the numbers in descending order now. Now I am going to search for a number 44 and let's see 44 is present at location 2. So by just making a single change in the symbol, that is less than or equal to and greater than or equal to, appropriately you need to write down and it will give the correct result. Now let's change it to greater than symbol to less than symbol. And now let's re-execute a code. Now keep in mind the list should be in the ascending order. Now let's insert the values in ascending order. And now I want to search the number say 22, which is not present in my list. And let's check whether the output is correct or not. Yes, the output is not found. 22 is not present in the list. Re-execute a code with the same value again. And now let's check what is the output for any valid number which is present in my list. Now let's check 33 and let's check whether it's giving the output. Yes, 33 is present at location 1. So what I need to do is I need to make only a single change in my program. So if this is the program for ascending ordered list, what should be the symbol? It should be the less than. The value present in the mid is less than the key value in that position, in this case my symbol is less than or equal to less than symbol, and this is the code for descending ordered list. And here I need to only make a change in the symbol, like it should be greater than. So in this way you can perform both the functions accordingly the list, because in binary search it is mandatory to have your list in sorted form, that may be either in ascending order or in descending order. So by making a single simple change in your program, you can change the output accordingly. So thank you dear friends for listening my video. Please do not forget to give the comment. If you like the content and the video, please like the video and subscribe my channel Tech Talks. I am providing you the subscription link as well, and do not forget to keep the bell ringing, because ringing bell will give you the notification of new videos. Thank you friends. Here are the some useful links are also available for you. Go through it and enjoy the study. Thank you.